Welcome back to Newly Released. My name is Sass Queen Amy, and I am joined once again by the other Frost. Welcome along, folks over here on Twitch, over on YouTube. As always, your support goes a long way to keeping streams like this around. And of course, supporting all the new favorite streams, like exploring the Zelda series with Jesse and maybe Casey.
Maybe Casey, yeah.
We don't know.
Still not sure.
We don't know. This week, we are checking out Cassette Beasts, which, if you haven't already, I did a 3-minute review for this. Oh my god, she came out of retirement. I did a 3MR on this. I really, really loved this. I had a lot of fun with it. Mousecatcher saying, hey Amy, I just finished the main story and I cried. I'm glad you enjoyed it. I got pretty emotional at the ending too, like just because I was like, oh dang. What a game. It's a really, really good time. Thank you for us for dropping the link over in YouTube chat.
Yeah, Twitch, you're getting nothing.
Twitch, it's alright. Someone will find it for you, I'm sure. But which we mean, not us. So is this a Nexomon like? No, it's so different in its own way. I guess we'll just start from the start. Actually, I've intentionally left this on the screen, so I want to share with everyone what happened to me when I jumped into this game to write the review. So I was like, alright, pressing the game, let's go, it's going to be great. I pressed play, and Nick D's nuts trolled me from the goddamn Escapist Steam library.
From the get-go.
From the get-go, I was like, is this a joke? Like, he only played 4 minutes of it, but it was there, and I just thought everyone deserved to see that. It was my character by the end. At goddamn level 56. But we'll open up an empty file.
Speak, you tried. That's amazing. And Andrew Hickenbottom, 2-pound laser beak is the best cassette beast. Is that a beast? Is that one? I'm not sure. Hello, is this Pokemon with guns? No, that's Power World, which hasn't come out yet.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that one.
I'm excited for that one.
Oh, your favorite companion was Felix. I was a big fan of, oh my god, I'm forgetting her name now.
You wasn't that big a fan then, eh?
No, I was, but I'm just completely, it's 6 a.m. Frost. There's only so much my brain can do.
Name this after somebody in the chat. Name it after Mousecatcher. Favorite color. Wait, does that ever come up?
It does.
Really?
Your abilities and such. Like, some things use the color.
What? Neat. If you call this character nuts, the load screen will say D's sassy nuts.
Yeah. Oh, did someone suggest that, or is that you? Oh, no, Lampy. Oh, okay, that's
Lampy,
too good.
Yeah.
That's Lampy too being good. Degenerate. I gotta do that. I like bowl cut.
Snippets and your lack of Transformers. Michael Bay hasn't made a new one. Bowl cut, where? I love a good bowl cut. A cat headband.
Damn straight.
In honor of Nick, yeah. Smell a Steam Deck game, right? That's what I'm saying. These are the kinds of games I would play if I ever stumbled across a Steam Deck in the wild. I'm frying potatoes. When are they done? Well, taste as you go. Don't do that. 20 buckaroos is the price? It's actually pretty cheap. And if you have Game Pass, it's on that as well. Right now, it is $17.99 with a 10% discount. Juicy.
Oh, I didn't know about the 10% discount.
Yeah, overwhelmingly positive. This is a Game of the Year material. A little gaudy action. Need Game Pass on Steam Deck already? I heard you could like do some weird emulation stuff for it. I don't trust it. I'd break it.
We don't talk about it.
No. Dumpa.
Look at my little character. Let me just finish off with my tea.
You in the water? Oh, you're drowning.
I've just washed up on a beach, Frost. That's all I've done. I've just washed
like
up on a beach.
The start of Inception, I think. This is a Christopher Nolan-like? Wow, it's very dramatic for wood.
A little bit.
I wish Minecraft had that.
It's so weird bike. Not having the big boy dash.
Do you heal your damaged cassette beast by sticking a ballpoint pen into them?
Correct.
You can just use your finger. Did Simba win? We'll never know.
The music is so loud, but chat might be like, it's really quiet. And I'm like, oh no, not again.
Let me check them out real quick here.
Because to me, it's very loud.
It's also loud on YouTube.
Cool.
I'd just put it down a smidgen.
Okay, so this is what's really cool. So instead of being given like starter options and it's like, which one do you want? You get two options. And it's like, what's your aesthetic? Is it spooky or is it sweet? And I went with sweet the first time around.
Sweet, obviously. All right.
And then the top one is like, it's like little dying sheep thing.
Wait. Oh. So this is the edgy, angsty Spider-Man 3 versus the more manic kind of sugar high thing going on. All right. What's up, Bobby? Yeah. That's cute.
But you can get both, which is cool. And you can actually buy more of them because you get options.
Bandsheep. Wow.
It's called Bandsheep. The eerie moans of the wild bandsheep at night have led many to believe that they are restless, undead spirits, but this is untrue. They are very much alive. They just like to have a little bit of a whine. Who doesn't? So you just put in your cassette player, put on the headphones, and off you go.
Out here, fighting with my jump man. Love it. Oh?
I prefer my run man. Yeah, so you are the beast.
I am the beast. Oh,
the
we
beast.
Transform. Okay. Holy hell, it's like chaotic.
Oh, yeah. What I like about it is that, and at first I was like, like it just expects you to accept that very quickly. And you do. And I actually think that's to its benefit. Because it's like, yeah, it's weird. Get over it. And you're like, okay, I'm over it. Sick. It's amazing. I love that. Now, instead of each individual traffic crab. Oh, I absolutely demoed it.
A little OP. The balance could use some balancing.
To be fair, it's your first one. It needs to teach you how to do it.
It should be three boss fights and a must fail.
Nice to meet your acquaintance, Nuts. Anyway, we should probably get warmed up before you freeze to death in your pajamas. She's Irish.
Is she?
Yeah.
This is very pretty. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, this is Harbour Town. Pretty quaint, right? Where am
I? Super stylized, super nice.
Welcome to Harbour Town. Your new home.
Sea.
My new home? Right, yeah, sorry. I'm not very good at this, but I don't know how to best break the news. You're stuck here. We all are. Oh, I don't feel so good.
It's an isekai. Oh, you died again.
You.
Can't believe it. Andrew Hickenbottom, 2 pounds. So did Simba win? We never got to see. Nah, he died. He died.
Yeah, it was the gritty alt ending.
Yep. Did not get the true ending.
It's the alt ending Disney didn't want you to see.
Yep. Deleted scenes version.
There is like single line kind of voice acting in parts.
It's that visual novel, like, hey, whoa.
Yeah.
One line. Yeah.
That being said, kind of spoilers, not spoilers. There is a character that comes up later that a good chunk of their dialogue is voiced. And it's by Yuri Lowenthal.
Oh, not Brendan Urie.
Not Brendan Urie.
My second favorite Urie.
Is that true? Like, you know, I'm a massive Panic and Fall Out Boy fan, correct? Like,
absolutely.
Okay, good. Just checking. You haven't told her? Oh, I should have. Not to info dump on you, but we're on an island called New Warol. It's not strictly on Earth, at least that's what we think. Is there a way back home? I'm afraid not, Nuts. I'm so sorry. Castaways have been trying to get their world back to their worlds for a century and have not succeeded. But you'll be all right. It's community in Harbour Sound.
Purgatory. Oh, my God.
It's a literal purgatory.
That's amazing. A little grit.
No, but it's not random because they do, like, most of their, like, lead lines, like, the first lines they say typically are voiced. It's one of those kind of things. So it didn't feel disjointed when that character came in. And again, it'll kind of make a little bit more sense. Someone tell Marty this is basically Lost. Honestly, it is.
Amazing. Hey, Dimitri. I've been having a good time. How about you, Amy?
I've been up for exactly 40 minutes. So I guess my day's going pretty good. I'm playing video games. Worst things I could have started my day with.
Bit of breakfast heroin. It's not good for the tummy on an empty stomach. What is this music? It's very involved.
Is the music that plays in the town?
I don't think I've played a Moncatcher with, like, with words in their music.
It does make a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Now, the good news is now we can pick a sick outfit.
Oh, yeah, let's go. Give her a gun.
We can catch the gun one later.
Do Aussies get a bank holiday Monday like the Brits?
No.
Imagine not.
No.
If it's a British holiday, I'd imagine not.
We have lots and lots of public holidays. None this week. Queenslanders have today, though, which is annoying.
But worried I was late still in character creation? No, this is the second character creation.
This is the second character creation.
You missed the first one, so you might as well just wait till the third character creation comes through. Ooh, a roguelike. No.
No.
A Moncatcher. Just very involved with its character creation.
I liked making mine like as 80s as possible.
I think I would have made mine look like Bruce Lee in his most famous yellow tracksuit. I'm a banana.
I'm a banana. Yeah, I really liked... and if you've seen the review, you'll have seen my character in the footage. Oh, because I don't have... Oh, disappointing. She said she was going on patrol. We're going on patrol. She needs to tutorialize us.
I'm on patrol. That was the crazed golf. Got pretty heated. Couple bloody noses.
Oof, that doesn't surprise me. Genuinely, that doesn't surprise me. How much hand-holding will there be? It does need to teach you the mechanics because it is a fair bit more complex than... something like Pokemon's mechanics because of its chemistry status effect system. But once it does that, it's like, okay, have fun.
Then it turns into a Souls-like right after the tutorial.
No.
This is like, well.
But that's for you to decide.
I want a game with so much hand-holding, it just squeezes the life out of you. You
like,
actually
through
just
your hand.
The tutorial. Oh, your real hand, yeah.
Sounds like some demonic shit right there.
The game is just try to get out of the tutorial. See, I personally like the one-liners or the sounds before the thing that you read.
It works in this. In this.
I read way faster than the things are voice acted, so at my own pace.
No, I 100% agree, because for anyone that remembers one of my reviews from late last year on Beacon Pines, I loved that game the second I turned narration off, because I wanted to hear myself reading the book,
not this random person. And after I did that, I was like, oh, this game's amazing. But until I did that, I was like, oh, I don't know how I feel.
Stop reading to me. You're just walking up on Spring Heel. It's Batman.
It is Batman.
Look at this guy. Oh, sicko. Buddies. I can't tell
he
a friend or foe.
Sicko. So this is what I was mentioning earlier, but then we won so quickly I didn't get to finish it. So in this game, you have action points, which are for the most part related to your character over your mond, of your cassette beast. So if you don't have enough action point for a move, you just won't be able to move. Or do anything. So each party members get 2 action points per turn and an extra 1 if they land a type advantage attack. So you can plan ahead, save up for your powerful attacks, or you can just spend the lower ones early.
All right. Oh, he's all up in there. Wow. Roundhouse.
Yeah, so your monster form has health, but your character has health as well. You might break the tape and need to repair it, so, like, heal the characters. But any extra damage from the attack, it effectively has, like, a trample effect where it'll actually hit you. And right. So if you and your companion both die, you're out. So there's this interesting layer of trying to look after yourself as well. But you, yeah, it's quite interesting.
Oi, sis. What's both of yous' favorite fizzy soft drink? Pepsi Max for life here. I was shocked to find that quite rare in the US. So, because we already tolerate Pepsi. You're telling me a low-cal, sugar-free version of Pepsi exists? And what's the point?
Nah, Pepsi Max isn't the sugar-free one, is it?
Yeah, it's the low-cal, sugar-free one.
I don't know. I don't drink it. I don't know.
Right. Favorite fizzy soft drink? Probably just a little Baja Blast Mountain Dew. And I do pronounce the J.
Oh, I know what the puzzle is.
I'm not a big soft drink guy. I only have it on special occasions.
Now,
so
see,
it is poison? Yes.
I say lemonade.
It's not fizzy.
Yes. No, because when we say lemonade, we just mean Sprite.
Oh, what?
Yes.
Well, see, this is why
I love
these
streams. I go to a restaurant and I say, give me a lemonade. And they're like, here's your Sprite. Lemonade, I don't want what other people call lemonade. No. I want Sprite. Lol.
It's amazing.
Straya! Get it, Dimitri. Yeah, so cool. So I just got Kaylee as my companion. She comes with her mon. Her mon is Sirenade. Sirenades are particularly loud creatures, like me, and can amplify their own singing voices through their microphone, tails, and wings. They don't seem to have much awareness to whether or not their singing is too loud for those around them.
Poor thing.
It is literally me.
So, poor thing. Vietnamese salty lemonade. Is that also Sprite? Is that a different thing?
That sounds like a different thing.
Maybe it's the same. I don't know.
Do you need a break, Nuts? We can rest here if you'd like.
The legendary Baja Blast. Yeah, I think I like it because it is so rare. It feels like it is a special occasion. So also very different. But any kind of... Ooh, I'd say ginger ale. I'm always keen on trying one. Mm-hmm. Da-da. Cigarettes, vaping, alcohol, soda, keep all of it away from me. How can you know you how can you live if you haven't felt something that makes you want to die?
I mean, again, typically Sprite doesn't make me want to die.
No. Unless it's that McDonald's Sprite, when they get the ratios just right, oh, that is liquor.
Now, see, interestingly, when I was in America, I discovered that all of yours don't use the sugar-free one anymore. Whereas all of the Australian ones swapped so that we have to use that shit sugar-free Sprite from McDonald's. I actually can't drink it anymore. I said to Alex the other day, I'm like, you actually can't give that to me because I feel sick for the rest of the day.
because it's so, so weird. So anyway, I need to get thick shakes from McDonald's now. But normal Sprite doesn't do that to me. I don't know.
Right. Strange that. Huh. Oh, what's this? Mariam with a member for 36 months. Oh, early access.
Yeah.
Amy, you've inspired me to join the gym.
Oh, I hope you're having a ton of fun. I'm proud of you. So I tell everyone at the end of all my classes too. I'm always proud of you. You should be proud of you too.
Yeah, sign up for Amy's courses, just at least for the pat on the back, if you're not going to work out. Got to a stage where I only drink the sugar-free fizzy drinks now. See, I'm an all-in kind of guy. Just a man of extremes. I want the full force. Give it to me. No. Caffeine-free? No. Sugar-free variant? No. I just won't do it.
It's all they'll give us.
Yeah. Like vaping? No. I'm not going to vape. I'm either going to roll my own. I don't know what. Roll my own cigarettes.
I'd prefer it to be...
Or nothing.
Yeah. Roll your own cigar.
Yeah.
Because there's just something really beautiful about that thought. Like,
yeah, if we're gonna hurt ourselves, we'll just go full throttle for it. It's like, whenever I go... Because every now and again, I go on a vegan diet, just for funsies. I don't go for plant-based meat alternatives. I just have me a curry, a veggie curry, Thai food, any, you know, whatever the vegetables excel at, that's what I'm going to have. I'm not going to pretend and wish that it were meat.
Now, see, I am the type of person that's like, yes, there is a burger place near us that does this incredible... Like, I typically prefer a fish burger, and again, I'm not getting into this argument, it's a burger. A fish burger, or a veggie burger, but I hate, like, if it's a veggie burger that's like, here's a patty with chickpeas in it, I'm like, fuck off with that armpit. Like, I don't need that. Go away. The best ones are where they actually, like you've said, like, just use an ingredient. Like, here is an eggplant, and here is some halloumi, and we put it on the burger for you, and it's going to be amazing. And you're like, thank you. This is beautiful. And there's another one. There's a place here called Betty Burgers. And they have a mushroom patty, but it's like filled with cheese. So it's just mushroom and cheese, and that's like the patty. And oh my God, it is to die for. And I'm like, see, this is what happens when you don't just go, we'll get it as close to it as possible. It's like, don't do that. Don't give me that. Right?
Yeah, you got to love yourself. You gotta love yourself.
Before you can love somebody else. Can I get an amen up?
Be you. You know? The mushrooms excel at being mushrooms. They're never gonna replace a rib or something. Miriam, £99. Thanks, Amy. I want to better my mental health. That's a great way to go.
Heck yeah.
No half measures, pretty much. Rolling a cigar is even worse, yeah. But again, if it's gonna hurt me, let's go all the way. Dun-dun. I think it's because I drank, I drank diet soda as a kid without consent, and it threw me off. Where I just go, something's wrong with this drink, but it said Pepsi. Oh no, it was Coke. Ugh. Diet Coke is just so strange. I wouldn't even say gross, it just feels like something different's happening to you. So who's this guy?
That's Dominoff, and he's gonna teach us how to fly. A little bit.
Oh, it's amazing.
Not quite fly. He's going to teach us how to fly.
Hover a bit, right?
Yeah.
So, Scott Lampy. I tried vegan scrambled eggs once, which said it tasted just like real scrambled eggs. Pretty sure the vegan who made it had forgotten what eggs tasted like. Maybe, yeah. Possible.
So one of the things about catching the beasts in cassette beasts that I thought worked really, really well is it comes down to chance, but that chance is always visible. So when you start the recording to catch the beast, what happens is there's several factors that affect the probability of success. So it'll give you the initial chance, and then like if you attack them while, it'll go up. It's level, like there's a whole heap of things that go into it. But yeah, debuffing them, buffing your attacks, they're effective ways to increase the damage and improve the odds. As long as a monster is being recorded, it can't flee or be defeated. So you can over-attack it to effectively...
That's so good.
Yeah, but as long as you're recording it, it can't die, which is great. Amazing. Yeah, so yeah, it just gives you extra
amount of
chance.
Times, like I'm trying to catch something, but I have to kick its ass, but not completely murder it.
Yes.
And I was like, well, I can't use my main guy for this. Unfortunate.
And then here it's teaching you about stickers, which I didn't use as much as I probably could have. But yeah, it's cool. It's very, very cool. So anyway, we've recorded it now. And so because it was the first mod I caught, I can just transform into it now.
It's amazing. I like to think that your character has a big cassette case, just keeping all these cassettes.
Oh, they do. Beautiful. Much akin to Pokemon, they only ever have six, so six at a time, which is cool. And then what happens?
Oh, yeah, good point. Is there a day and night cycle, or is this just
there
for the
indeed.
Story?
No, there is indeed. I wish... So it changes when you rest. And sometimes I was like, wish it was a little bit more daytime in this area. But that's also fine. Like, it's totally fine.
So Minecraft, neat. It's lovely. Mom used to make me drink apple cider vinegar and lemon juice when I was sick as a kid. I'd rather stay ill. Oh, but it was good for you. God, yeah, the amount of homeopathic cures my grandparents would give me. They were so bad. That's so bad. That's where I got that saying of like liquor. It's just it tastes so bad. It has to be good for you. No, it's just poison.
So no.
Oh, yeah, fun poison.
Alright, so now I can glide.
Already? Wow, look at that. See, in Pokemon, you'd have to go through I don't know 3 gyms. Oh no, wait, that's swimming. No, yeah. Lovely. Oh. For some reason we had ginger ale for a sore throat. Yeah, growing up Hispanic, we used baking soda and everything. Everything. It was the bubbles. It cures what ailed
bubbles!
You.
Bubbles! I love bubbles.
How much does the day and night cycle affect the beasts, Amy?
I can't say I ever noticed. So I don't think it does. That being said, the ones that were here are now not here.
Interesting. You talk about the Impossible Whopper in the chat. Whenever they make an impossible food, that's when I go to the fast food and I say, "Give me a real one, and give me the impossible one." And but just use the same wrapper for me. I want to trick myself and see if I can tell the difference.
So someone asked if the way to fix a
Oh yeah, it is.
It is a pencil. You literally use a pencil to fix it.
Oh my god. This is the Pokemon killer.
It's like genuinely, again, if you've seen my review, you know most of my thoughts. I did have a really good time with this game. One of the big things I'll say about it is when, like, my first Pokemon games were like Fire Red and Leaf Green, moving then into Hoenn region, so Sapphire, Thingo, and Emerald. Emerald, to me, is the best Pokemon game they've ever made. The whole time I was playing Violet, I was like, fuck, I just wish I was playing Emerald. The whole time. The whole time, that was all I wished. And this, to me, and everyone's experience of what they think Pokemon is very different, which is why I would never try and explain, like, oh, this is what you remember Pokemon being like, because what I remember Pokemon being like is very different to other people. When I say that, what I mean is there is a nice challenge to it. It's never so overly challenging that you get frustrated. But everything about this, in terms of its freedom and the different options you have to pursue, different storylines, to me, all of it just worked together really nicely. And when you, the biggest thing that I think lets this down is one of the things we're going to come across in the session today is the rangers, which are like your Pokemon gyms. And I instantly went, I want to do those first. There is local co-op. And if you'd watched my review, you would know that. That says you didn't watch my review, because I literally bring it up and show you on screen how to do it. Unfortunately, Alex is asleep. I cannot get him to come and join me. But it's literally as simple as, like, Alex just plugged in the controller, pressed A, and off we went. Like, it's literally that simple. It's so good. It's so good.
Amazing.
But yeah, it just all of that's to say, the biggest thing about it was I wanted to go and do the gyms first, and you kind of like the gym equivalents first, and you kind of can't. But there is a feature that's kind of locked behind beating the game, and people coming from Pokemon are going to have an expectation that that's something they can do earlier. But like, it's totally fine. Just know you can't beat them all and just pursue everything kind of as you go. But it unlocks all these new things once you finish the game. And I just think that's so cool. And so that to me was a big up, is like, the game is not done. There is still so much more, to explore with this world. And I thought that was really, really awesome.
Absolutely bizarre. What's that thing? What?
What's what?
A little guy down there.
Just what little guy?
Right there in front of you. Oh, are we starting to fight? What's happening? Huh? Yeah, me too, huh?
Never. What's going on?
Hey, Frost, I want to impress a girl by cooking her some good-ass food. What's an easy but simple dish? Salmon bites. Here's a, I grabbed the link
salmon
for you.
Salmon bites? See, yes, I love salmon. I love salmon.
Salmon bites, very delicious, very crispy.
Are these salmon bites by Nick Kroll?
Who is it? Nick Kroll?
It said Kroll's Corner.
Is it? I don't know. I just grabbed a random one. But it seems to have it. It's just delicious panko salmon bites with a bit of Parmesan. Serve it on rice with some veggies if you want. Bang bang sauce. Good stuff. But here's a secret. If you want to be a romantic when it comes to food, there really isn't a food in itself that is romantic. Find one that lets you show off a little in the kitchen itself. That's where you cook up l'amour.
That's l'amore.
Share the link in Twitch. I can't, Lampy. I like this guy. Dandelion? That's me.
I know. How sick is Dandelion? Like, the second I saw that, I was like, I want it. I never caught it on my other playthrough, and now I'm devastated.
Look at that. There it is.
Look at him. Yeah. He's such a good one.
Love this style. Amazing.
Oh,
passion
fruit
isn't romantic.
No. all the monsters I just adored here. I just thought that was so neat.
Carny Viper, Dandelion. How many beasts are there? Do you know?
120. But there's like 1,000 combinations from the fusions.
God.
Mm-hmm. I was never going to find any of them. But I did want to catch the 120.
Right. Chat, when Pokemon says they have like 100 mons, does that include evolutions or?
The 120 does include evolutions.
All right. I don't know how I feel about this. Romantic foods up to the cook isn't to set the scene as you show the hard work you put into the dish. I mean, you don't have to tell them it was easy. Exactly. It's all about showing off your knife work, your attention to detail. I'd say salmon's a show-off food.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Especially if you get it in with this, if you get a piece that's got the skin on it and you have to prep it yourself. It shows a bit of dexterity.
Is that not how all of your salmon comes?
No, we can get it just in like just bits already cut up.
Oh.
No.
No, fast it's most of the time. Oh, so this is really cool. So the stickers and like the move sets, you can get like rarer ones. And they typically have extra effects. It's really cool. Very cool. Never figured out what the wheat was for.
Not sure.
All right, here's where shit starts getting a bit weird.
As if it wasn't. Oh, you're right. This is weird.
Oh, it's about to, like.
Holy.
What?
Same. See, yeah. Do you really want someone to read all that? I think, what is enough for me?
It's funny because there is one game I reviewed, and I think about this review all the time, called Paradise Killer. And I think back on it because I'm like, fuck me, that game was good. Like, I think back on it all the time because I'm like, wow, that game is amazing. But at the time when I reviewed it, I'm like, man, I found the one-liners really jarring because it was like the same four one-liners and it didn't match the tone of what they were saying. And for some reason, it just threw me off. But I feel like I was way harsher on it at the time than I actively think back about that game. Paradise Killer, if y'all like sleuthy stories and you haven't played it or watched my 3M offer it, go play it. It's so good. It nails its landing so hard. So good. Yeah, so we're like, one thing about the story that I did say in my review for Cassette Beast is I was like, okay, it, like the story itself, a little bit lackluster. But one thing I think it does do really well is all this weird stuff. You're so lulled into it by this point. Like, you're 30 minutes in and you're like, okay. Like, yeah, like you transform into cassettes. Like, this is normal, right? And you're like, this is normal. And they're like, God, no. And you're like, oh, okay. Like, this is weird.
Yes, I love that.
Yeah, you're like, no, this is normal. They're like, it's not normal. And you're like, oh. And so it really just throws you out. I don't know. It just works so well. It works so
I'm not
well.
Sure. Like, I'm not sure what to call that. I refer to it sort of as Wonderland weird, where everything is weird.
That's a great way to explain it.
But then there's still some things within the Wonderland where they go, oh, God, that's weird. So you're just thrown for a loop as if everything was already normal. Okay. What's to go here?
I feel about Pokemon. The music's weird.
Everything. Everybody. It's abandoned and just came up out of the ground. The abandoned subway station.
See, how do I feel about Pokemon inspired things? I wasn't going to do reviews again. This game got announced while we were in America, while Nick was with us. And I looked at it and I said, give that to me when it comes out. And it dropped in our review channel and I was like, I was messaging. I'm like, thank God I'm in the States. And I was like, let me.
I'm in the States.
I was like, I'm coming out of retirement. Give me. Because I just quite like Pokemon likes because I'm always interested to see how they do it. And again, like Nexomon was like my game of the year that year. Like I loved Nexomon Extinction. And I really like this as well. I really, really like this as well.
Creepy, creaky. Oh, it's a bit of plastic.
Yeah.
God, we've ruined the earth forever. Plastics and everything. You go into an abandoned crypt that came up out of nowhere and there's plastic in there. Imagine.
It's not a crypt. It's a train station.
Even worse. Like, imagine you get isekai and there's a Kit Kat wrapper there. Well, oh.
Oh, yeah. It gets weird.
All right.
It gets weird.
I like this. Give me more Lavender
this
Town.
This is what got me, right? My number one thing, and I'm not sure if this has been fixed post, release, I wish there was an option to turn off the moving text. One, for accessibility. Two, I found it quite hard to read. Yeah. So is that you, Mordred? Come closer, child, so that I may see you one last time.
So this is a kid's game?
This is not a kid's game, I would argue. I would argue it's like teenager. The long conflict has drawn to an end. I'm afraid he has defeated me truly this time. I think this is an archangel. We need to leave now. This isn't like the other monsters. We are not safe here. No, you are not my kin. You come for me once again, sword in hand.
Oh.
And then you have to fight Archangel Morgante, broken spirit.
Gee, we had, you know, like, dandelion, and now it's just a broken spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Tone took a bit of a turn. I like it.
The tone takes a massive turn, and you're like, whoa, 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 what?
How long is the game? How long did it take you, would you say?
It's much longer than you think. I think I had about 16 hours by the time I finished, and that was... there was still heaps more to do. But I finished it in about 16.
Oh, wait. It's on Game Pass, they'll tell you. Give me a sec. I will find that for you. It's probably my favorite feature of Game Pass, just seeing game length on there.
So Archangels have a slightly different mechanic with their action points. So they accumulate them all, and when they reach level 10, it's probably going to kill you unless you do something about it. Yeah, it's smart. It's smart. I like it a lot.
Main story plus extras are 27 hours. It doesn't have the main story only or the completionist stuff yet, but that's a bit of girth.
Yeah. Yeah, it's about a 50-hour game, to be honest. I refuse. Now, is this going to work? Because I didn't update it. Oh my god, it actually worked. Now, weirdly...
Banade?
The fusion Banade? Didn't work Banade? For me in my initial playthrough, and I'm like, I don't understand what's going on.
God.
Yeah, and I was so confused. I'm like, I don't understand. I still somehow beat the Archangel, but oh my god, I was so confused.
Music's intense for this one. You don't feel like you're in a Pokemon game. You feel like Pokemon the show.
Yeah, it's because you fused. Oh god, she's killed me. Oh no, they kept me alive.
Nah,
oh,
good. It's a good thing she's level 100.
Yeah, Nero Patty in the chat, welcome on in, saying like my initial playthrough took 30 hours for the main plot line. Again, for the purpose of reviewing it, I tried to kind of just push through as quickly as I could. So it took me about 16 hours. If I was taking my own time with it, I would have taken way longer because I would have spent more time doing other stuff. Because that's how I like to enjoy these kind of things. Last cause asking, so this is basically Digimon meets Final Fantasy. Another reviewer said it, and I completely agreed, because the whole time I was playing this, I would look over at Alex and be like, man, this is giving me Persona vibes. It has Persona vibes, and that's the best way I can kind of explain it. Yeah.
Playing games for fun, that's insane. We don't have time for that. Schedule.
That's some decent value. When I saw the price, I was like, this is a big game by a small team. And like, that's why I can't recommend it enough, because I think its price point is just so spot on. And it's on Game Pass. I just think this game is great, and I think people should play it. Mm-hmm. I just think it's awesome.
Frost, when are you going to play Persona? First game I'll play on a Steam Deck. I'm not doing that at a PC. You're sick.
Enough! My time is drawing to an end. Why have you come to this wretched place? I want to go home. I see. There is a way. There are none who know the path but I. I required a vessel and you require a guide. Rebuild my strength and in turn I shall lead you from this land. Vessel? Very well. Hear my song.
Oh. I don't know how I feel about this. Oh, she's in her head.
She's in her head. If you wish to leave this land, then heed my words and hear my song. You must rise to the task at hand. You must walk the path most long. The rest of the song is currently too quiet to make out.
Let's get Persona on Switch. That's a point, but Nintendo doesn't do sales.
Yeah.
It's also on Game Pass.
Oh, yeah, I just remembered her storyline. Yeah, so there are archangels in the world. They're creatures that look and feel wrong. Like, you can just tell that they aren't meant to be in this place. Those other creatures, though, they're still archangels to us. We don't know what they are. No one has really seen them for a long time. Looking at that thing we fought, it's hard to explain. It felt like I wasn't viewing it correctly, like trying to watch a movie through binoculars. We're all from different worlds, after all. You might not know what movies are.
It feels like me at the start of this stream. Do they know what cassettes are?
Yeah. I do know what a cassette is. I have indeed seen a cassette tape. Okay, grand. And everyone gets so awkward the first time they fuse, because you do need to unlock that ability with each of the companions. Oh, and I lied. I was going to say that awesome lady was my favorite companion. That is a lie. Barkley. The second I got Barkley, I'm like, this is all I need. I only need Barkley. Barkley is a dog. Like, just a dog that has his own cassette tape. Oh, and his name is Barkley. God. And he's so beautiful. And I love him. Love him.
Aren't cassettes those things you used to see tangled in bushes and trees at the side of the road?
That is correct.
What? I never found one of those.
What? You never found a cassette tree?
A cassette just... No, I did not. Sorry. Yeah.
That Archangel, her memory is inside you. She knows a way to leave New Warol. If there is even a chance this can lead to a way off this island and return people to their homes, we owe it to everyone to find out. You and I, what do you say? Let's do it.
Oh, look at that. It's a romancer, too. Friendship symbol.
The fusion not working. That's why I didn't say anything about it. I was like, this will have been a bug. I was like, it was a bug. I didn't even stress about it. I was just like, I hope it works for the stream, because I haven't patched the game, I don't think, since reviewing it. Because again, that was the only issue I came across. Literally the only one. And I was like, oh, that's fine. I was like,
you god dang game developers giving us buggy previews. I want to be a diva. Just be like, nah. Are you finished? Are you finished now? Can I review it now? Are you done? That's too much.
Bring that up to me at the end of stream. Bring that up to me at the end of the stream.
So you're done.
But yeah, anyway. It's cool. So now we have a couple of different quest options.
I want to be the very best.
But like no one ever was. I sing some of the words to that wrong, and I can't remember what it was. No, maybe it's not that song. I can't remember. Oh, hey, it's Felix. It's husbando.
Oh, there's vampires there?
Maybe.
No, they're just pasty.
I'm not going to say anything.
Okay. See, this is my favorite part of a Wonderland, figuring out what's logical and what's not, even though it's all weird to me.
I've fought your kind before on one. Do you want a demonstration?
Oh, there's racism here.
Yeah. Nah, nah, nah. Wait, no, this isn't Felix? Oh, shit, no. I was wrong. This is Eugene.
By Eugene.
No, Felix is awesome. I love Felix. I just remembered who Felix was. No, Felix is awesome.
Eugene.
Yeah, his name's Eugene.
Strikes fear into the hearts of many.
And whatever you do, don't invite them into your house. That's what they want.
That's amazing. Hey. A few weeks ago, I asked if there was a way to have a healthy relationship with social media. I realized I was addicted to my phone. I've gone down from a 9-hour average to 3 to 2-hour one. Well done.
Well done.
Fantastic. Yeah, no, I joined you, Miriam. I took a lot of stuff off my phone. It almost doesn't even function anymore.
I feel like I actually just took parts out of it. It's a whole, yeah, it's a pieces. Weird thing now.
I took the screen off. Meet me at this location. All right, Eugene. Now we got to fight Eugene. He just says anybody can get it. Okay.
Yeah, so now we've got we can go meet with Eugene, or we can go head to the outpost for the Rangers. I feel like the Rangers opens up more, so let's do that. And then he can just pick up random quests from people. He wants to put up a fancy town sign. So he just wants some wood.
That's adorable. And look at him. Nice, bald old man.
Now this is unlocked so we can get up faster.
Ooh. It's a Metroidvania.
Whee. Oh man, I miss my dash.
Oh, that's right. You can do your little glide thing now.
I can do my little glide thing now.
Look at that. See, you get to... I don't know if you can do that nowadays in Pokemons, but I always did find it weird that I had to stand next to a thing and select the extra ability instead of just, you know,
right?
Let me fly. Let me glide. Swim was okay, I guess.
Oh, I don't actually have a quest selected, lol.
Oh. That'll take me on. All right, Eugene.
No. Take me on is the Rangers quest line.
Oh, never mind. He asked for it.
They all have 80s song references. Like, what's his?
Really? Well, it's Take Me On. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah,
I get it now.
Take Me On.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Very clever
get
of
it?
You.
Uh-huh. Get it?
You left your friend.
It's all right. She pops back up.
Oh, okay. That's good. She's not very good at following you.
Look, she's not amazing, but it's fine.
Confident woman. I love it. No names, just confident woman.
Yeah, so now it just shows you what, like, the head of the Rangers can pull against.
Oh my god. Oh. Oh, that was level 8. You're level 60, lady.
Yeah. She's in charge for a reason, huh?
She's in charge. She's smurfing.
She's smurfing. We don't condone smurfing in these here parts. Ah, I'm not used to my dash being so low.
That's another carny, whatever it was. Carny Viper, I think.
Yeah, Carny Viper's cool. Oh man, I'm such a dickhead.
What'd you do now?
I really struggled to find the last ranger, and it was the lowest level one. And it's because, and when I eventually found him, I was so mad at myself. I was like, how did I miss that? Like,
Carny Viper and a Macabre. So like a combination of a goat and macabre.
Yeah.
Clever, clever. See, if anything, I'll defend Mon Games just because I want to see more of these strange names. They're
so
almost
I-
like puns.
Yeah, a lot of the names in this game are, what's its names? Like, just puns.
Oh. God, this music.
My favorite was, Faustus. Was it Faustus? Faucetess. And it's like this countess, but it's like this crying, like, fountain. I don't know, it was really cool. Like, when I saw it, I'm like, oh, I love it.
I love it.
Yeah, it was
do
this
they do
guy.
That? Do they make mons out of like inanimate objects, or is it actual animals? Hey man, Frost, trying to read more 100 books this year. What are some good reads? Unfortunately, I've read some stinkers. Let's see.
If you like Dragon Age, the Dragon Age books are all very good.
Lemony Snicket, Series of Unfortunate Events, just one of my favorite all-time series. I'm not telling you these are any good, I couldn't tell you, I just love them. Phenomenal stuff. Dun, 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 dun. Dun. Yahtzee's books, there you go.
Yeah, that's the next lot on my list, is Yahtzee's, yep. Once I've finished all of the Dragon Age ones.
Yep, Yahtzee's books, and then I'll probably grab Darren's, I'll probably alternate them. I want to see what he thinks of Christopher Nolan. He loved Lemony Snicket. Oh, well, there you go. Dang, now I have to say another one. The Bartimaeus trilogy was actually pretty good. Pretty good. Bartimaeus. The Immortal Nicholas Flamel. Good series. I'm not sure if it ended well. It's been a bit. Most of my reading ended at like 20. Then I got very busy.
That's the problem, eh?
Yeah. Like my reading abilities have actually taken a drastic hit because of my phone. Like, feel like I have to rehabilitate myself, so I've been getting back into slowly building up stamina with like poems and young adult fiction and stuff like that. Aren't you all writers? Writing's one thing, reading's another. Yeah. Aren't you all writers? Also depends on your writing
style. Spend that time writing.
Nice. Yeah. There you go. Have you all read Wool? Okay, I don't think I have.
No.
One Piece. That's a manga.
That's a manga.
Wait, why does she look like confident lady? Woman.
Because she is. She's just introduced herself.
Oh, that's cool. There.
What do you do here?
All right. That's a little random there, Paul. I so get mad at people who say that reading a book is the same as writing a paper. I've never in my 27 years on this rock heard anybody say that, but I think it would get me to
Oh. We just fought an archangel. What
archangels? Well,
oh, the Vile Village, that was like the saddest one. The the sawmill one probably is the one that I enjoyed the most. Da-da. Just because it teaches you how to read.
Oh, I need
what
to
do you
sneeze.
Think, nuts? Do you want to apply to join the Rangers, kid?
Yeah. Yeah, training is a task with meeting up with each of the Ranger captains here in New World and overcoming their challenges. Since you're a hot shot in monster combat, I'm pretty sure the captains are going to want to test their fighting abilities. So everyone else is a difference. So, like, Kaylee had to do something really basic.
That's cool.
Yeah. But for me, they made me fight them.
Oh. Talk to people, not rocks, Frost. I don't talk to people. I do. I'd say I've got a pretty good pulse on people. I'm a little closer to normie than games journalist, whatever that means.
I'm a little closer to normie.
Yeah. You talk like a wise old wizard. There's a lot of age in those years. Wait, what? A lot of experience in those years. See, I love mistakes.
People assume I'm old too.
Yeah, I love mistakes. So when I was younger, I set out to cause as many as possible. So that's how you learn. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, so you have time to read books, audio books. Oh, I don't know. I've never done one of those.
So here we go. At that point, once you've done the ranges, it's like, all right, now go have fun. Like, now just go do whatever you want. But if you want a bit of help or guidance, people with question marks are going to, like, just give you some assistance there.
I like it.
Yeah. Yeah, so you can collect some rumors. They'll help you out.
Marty is the alpha nerd. Marty's always got a game, a book, and a movie.
He really does.
At the same time. He's King Nerd at the Escapist.
King Nerd.
As far as like being super well-rounded, right? I'd give that to Marty.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no.
You know, Yahtzee's all about games. Darren's all on films. Marty's just super well-rounded. And reads. What a show-off. That's kind of nice. It just says, go, do your thing.
Yeah, so here is where it just becomes an open world. With different quest lines you can kind of follow.
Wait, why is his name Landkeeper? I don't get that. That pun just went...
No, it will make sense. We need to do Eugene's quest.
Daggummit. All right, Eugene. Coming for that ace. You're the wisest 27-year-old I've listened to. Poor Nick. Nick's the same age as me.
No, I think he's a bit older now. He's 28, right?
That's right, yep. Now, if for a few weeks, he can say, just wait till you're my age, Frost. You'll understand.
For a few brief weeks.
For a few weeks. Oh, she is Irish. I thought you were, like, making
no,
that up.
No, she's Irish.
Okay. Mousecatcher saying, did you find the level scaling pretty good, Amy? I found I never had too much 100%. Of an over-leveling problem.
Yep. I thought it worked really well. And the thing I thought it did very, very well on that note was... when you don't have the abilities and you're walking yourself to certain areas, what I thought was cool was there would be like a character in that general area that you would have to walk past and they'd be like, whoa, 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 like fight me. I don't think you're good enough to be here. And I thought that was a really subtle way of them being like, this is kind of roughly the level you're going into here. And, like, I was like, I killed the person, but barely, so I might go and do something else and come back. And I think it did a really nice job of that. Like, it didn't fully discourage me. It was like, you can keep going. It's just going to be harder. And I thought that was really, really nice, was just actually walking past those characters, having that encounter, and then being able to make that decision for myself. Whereas obviously the big problem with the most recent Pokemon, there were lots.
Oh, no.
Who am I kidding? Oh God, I'm on the train. Get me off. Get me off.
Get off the train. I even know. Come back.
One of the biggest issues with that was you'd be like, all right, I'm gonna go over here now. And then it's like, everything's like 40 levels higher than you or is 40 levels lower than you. And you're like, what is the point in me being here? Like the whole time I played that game, it all just felt wrong. Yeah.
I wonder how it'll fare for a chronic over leveler. Like that is my cozy game. I like over leveling in these kinds of games. I wonder if it's dynamic enough. I'm not sure.
I mean, if you want to overlevel, you can here.
Oh, I'm gonna. It's not a want. It's an illness I have. I need to do it, yes. I have to overlevel. If it has a system that can be leveled, I have to overlevel.
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, I went way too far.
I hope to be as mature as you one day, Frost. I have some growing up to do. Well, we all got growing up to do. Ain't gotta be so hard on yourself. In your own time, you know? I'm in no rush. But the fastest way to mature is to be as immature as possible. You only get to be a child once, and that's all your life.
Hey. You ready to take on the forces of evil? Yes.
Eugene, let's go. I'm ready.
All right, do you see that building over there? It's a stronghold. It's where these inhuman parasites form their dark plots to take over the world. Doesn't look that impressive. Well, looks to be deceiving, buddy.
Yeah, I feel like we're breaking into a rundown shack.
Their kind once plagued the world I came from, but we fought back. We won. There are a few of these strongholds. You might have seen them around. They lock the front doors, but we can drop in through a window on the roof. Try gliding over. I'll be on your side. Don't worry about it. And now we've got a Eugene.
My partner. Nice. Does this game throw too many monsters to catch at the start? Because that's how I always accidentally overlevel at the start, since I just fight with main monsters looking for something good.
No, there's definitely heaps to catch. But no, I wouldn't say so.
Amazing. Who has the name Kaylee and isn't Irish? People at Starbucks.
Well,
just asking, pleading for the barista to write their name the right way once. Just once.
Oh, man, you should have seen the amount of different ways people wrote KC. Oh, my God.
He told us that during golf with your enemies yesterday. Great.
We're taking down your operation, you leeches. You're being very uncooperative, young man. Why don't you listen to our sales pitch?
Oh, no.
I'm sorry. Did he just say sales pitch?
They sell vitamins here.
What do you mean? I thought they were vampires. They are vampires. Well, in a manner of speaking, I'd say they're worse than vampires. They're estate agents.
Eugene's a bigot.
The Land Keepers Association simply wants to formulate a long-term housing market within New Wirral. If you buy in now, you can make a significant profit from any future arrivals who will need housing. Since New Wirral has no currency, we even have a promising repossession scheme in development. Verdant enough, hey. Harbour Town will never be bought out by your kind. Are you ready? Let's show them what we're made of.
There you go. Who can argue with that logic? You don't want to buy a house? What's the weirdest way someone has misspelled your name? I said it yesterday. Rarely can anyone get Sebastian right, so I don't bother whenever they ask for my names. I'll say something easier, like Lucas. And for some reason, the lady wrote Rufus. I go, "That you're doing this intentionally. Surely. Yes, Henry. That's the one. That takes me back to middle school.
Oh, fuck, he just demoed him.
It's ruined your cassette. Pawn dead and spring heel.
Like, Eugene's, Cloxley's cool, but I didn't find it that strong. And I think it's because I think that's probably one of the biggest disadvantages is this is the first fight you are meant to do with Eugene. And the Mon types aren't an appropriate matchup. And so you're like, oh, he sucks.
Poor Eugene. He's not going to take much evil down at this rate. This poor guy.
Mm-hmm.
you actually poisoned a real life human being. I found the goth girl to be really strong. Oh, yeah?
The goth girl was good. Weirdly, I didn't use her that much because I think I got the old timey character. I don't want to spoil too much. I used her and I really liked her. Oh, my character's petrified, so all it can do is defend itself. Oh.
People rarely mess up my name because it's a well-known ocean and primary color. You're cute, but I feel like any time I hear someone get a normal-ish name, like you can totally spell this, they take it as a trick question.
Yeah, honestly.
It's like, there's no way, this is a trap. This is John with three O's.
In one of the shops we were in America, and then everyone was like, man, that must have been a really bad salesperson. I'm like, this is correct. What happened? They were like, and what's your last name? And I'm like, Campbell. And like, I kept trying to spell it and she just didn't get it. And I'm like, what? Campbell. And I'm like the soup. C-A-M.
Like the soup, yeah.
And then they're like, B. And I'm like, that is B. How you spell it. I'm like, oh my, well, cause it is. It's C-A-M-P-B-E-L-L. Yeah, yeah. And I'm like, oh my fuck. Like, people just amazing, don't get though. It. People don't get it.
See, but that reaction, though, just like, B, are you sure? Like, it's my name. Yes, I'm very sure. Yeah. Dun, dun. Find it, if you have a slightly foreign-sounding name, people really don't want to mispronounce it. Some? Oh, no, this gets butchered. They give you a new name if you want.
They give you a new name.
Give you a brand new one. Welcome.
Welcome to America.
No. All right, Eugene, you're going to have to pull your weight now. We're useless in that last fight.
Yeah, the amount of people that are writing like aware. Campbell. I need to work on my... Oh, I liked this piece of conversation. I need to work on my battle shouts. You're what? Yeah, like when I'm facing down some foes and just before I transform, I yell something cool, like, let's do this, or transform. Transform isn't very original. Look, it's an ongoing project, okay? What if I shouted, I'm going monster mode. Would that work? Do you think that sounds badass? Not at all. I'll come back to this another time.
All right, hear me out. What they should have done is let you suggest something where you type it out for him. And he shouts that every time. I would love that. I'd probably change it to something like Morbin Time. I'd know other people would just have him scream penis, probably. Because they're children.
Nick would. Nick is that.
Oh, God. Oh, that would have Nick just absolutely busting gut every time. Oh, man. Yeah, that would be right for abuse.
As we've just demonstrated.
Yep. Rumor has it who...
That kept going through my head every time I read that quest, and I was like, damn it.
Frost, change your name to Morgan Freeman and replace him when he passes. No, because then I'll get his spam mail.
Oh, God.
Awful. Unless it's a good coupon for a nice like, bit of Mazio's or something. Pizza's not that good, but when it's a dollar, hey...
Yeah, so here's like the Ranger notice board, and you have to complete your Ranger training before you can access those quests. And that's like a post-game thing. And I think that's pretty cool.
That is neat. Hey, hold on, dude. We are indeed having a good one. Little mana catching out here. Boom. Damn. The music is very good.
It is. It is. Hey, and this is the professor? Yes. He's not really a professor. He just wishes
Hoy Lake? Hoy Lakey?
Yeah, Hoy Lake.
Hoy Lake, all right.
I am talking of the scientific method. We must observe, analyze, and form conclusions. The humble townsfolk describe many strange beasts on this island. If we were to catalog them, then the unknown would cease to be unknown. I say, you look like you appreciate the importance of this task. Would you be interested in helping me identify some monsters?
Sure.
Excellent, wonderful. I have some descriptions of monsters I have sourced from Harbortown's populace. If you can record these monster forms, I'll be able to catalogue them. The first account I have is a fanged creature perched on a skull spotted in the park. Here are some blank takes to assist you in your research. Come on by when you've recorded it. I shall catalogue it. Happy hunting, my eager assistant.
I like his eagerness. Oh no, a man bun, also known as a bun.
A bun? On a man?
You know,
bun of man.
Just a bun. I'm working on mine. Oh, my hair has to grow out so much more. This will probably be the last time I go for long hair ever.
Like
I say that.
You say that as you're actively pursuing it.
What?
Long hair. Is that what you just said?
Yeah, I'm actively pursuing it. This will be the last time I go for long hair.
Why is this the last time?
All right. So, here's the thing that always had me a little paranoid. The thing about babies is you have to be careful with long hair in the household because it can wrap around their little baby fingers or something. Yeah, and it could cut off circulations. And I'll be hoping to have a child soon. So,
Knowing
for that, I was like, you know what? I'm going to try for long hair for probably the last time. Because odds are I go bald after the child's older.
Wow. Just like that. And instant bald.
You never know. Because, see, it'd be strange at like 40 to say, you know, I want to try some different hairstyles. But what's the point there if I go bald? So I'll just do it now just in case. Man buns look dirty. Oh, no. You're like all prim and proper. I bet you're sitting at your chair wearing jeans with a belt and khakis, aren't you? Very formal
and
all
khakis.
The time.
And khakis.
Clean shaven for gaming. Looking like you're at a call center. I like it.
It's my preferred way to game.
That's how I should show up to streams.
There was someone behind the wall.
Is it not warm where you are, Frost? It's a bit middling. It's all right.
It's cold here. I have two sets of pants on.
Because
when I woke up at 6 a.m., I was like... Well, 5:30 a.m. I was like... it's not that cold. But I don't want to sit here in my three-quarter pants.
Right.
So I put tracksuit pants over my other pants. Oh, man, Eugene sucks so much.
Poor Eugene. He's meant to teach you about these synergies. Yeah. You have a rat tail hairstyle. That'll probably, after I'm done with the long hair again, I'll finish it off with a rat tail.
Do it.
Yeah. That's what I enjoyed doing. I grow it all out and then chisel it down to something. So the last time it was long hair chiseled down to a mullet. It was beautiful. Gorgeous thing. Want it to be cold. I'm dying of heat. Oh, it's all about to be summer.
In summer. I really want to get an evolution out before the stream's up. And, we're close.
Is the party number for the game only limited to 2 people, Amy?
Yes.
Honestly, I prefer that. Because I would always have the main one that I would level, and then just one other one that I was leveling with the main one.
Well, as I mentioned in the review, what I really liked about this is... You're going back, you're exploring an area, you see a mon you haven't seen before, you want to catch it, but then it's like, well, what's the point? It's too low level, it's going to take too much time to level up. Well, fortunately, you don't have to worry about that, because, it levels to your companion level, not... the level you caught it at. And that was just great. That was so great.
Me too, George Lucas. I love the traffic crab. Best.
Now, see,
best
I was a big fan of Musketeer, the one that's on a carousel thing. Yeah. And I ended up finding a bootleg version. A bootleg version. That's what their shinies are called. It's incredible.
That's amazing.
Everything is so well done thematically in this game. I just think it's so great. Which is why I will continue saying, like, chat, if you, from what you've seen today, like, if you are a fan of, like, Pokemon-esque style games, and anything I've explained to you today, like, if you have any other questions about it, like, please ask now or forever hold your peace. Is their Master Ball just an iPod? Imagine.
Oh, God.
Yeah, because I just thought this was really, really fun. Yeah, bootlegs aren't necessarily that uncommon. Oh, equip that on Carnivipa. It's way better than Sharpen.
See, here's the thing. Bootlegs themselves would be common, but it's hard to find the same bootleg twice. There's a lot of things that I've had that were bootlegged that I actually adore as much as the real product that I can't get anymore.
And an interesting note on that one, right? Like, the bootlegs are, yes, are common-ish, but each of the different bootleg... the bootlegs have different types. Oh, God, I'm being chased. Oh, God.
Oh, look. Angry Pearson.
Angry Pearson.
Turns into Traveler, turns into a Thwackalope.
Yeah, the different thingamajiggies have different types. So you might find one bootleg is a different type to another bootleg. So there's all these different types in that. But yeah, oh man.
Amazing. Look at that. What's your favorite video game monster? Question for chat as well. Need to design some monsters for art class. Very video game monster.
Depends on the definition of monster. Oh, you got an astral bootleg Thwackalope? Oh, that's dope. That's so dope.
What is that? That's two prefixes. So bootleg is good. What's astral?
Astral is one of the types. One of the, like, elemental types. Okay.
There we go. My favorite video game monster. It's a very good one.
It is a good question. One I don't think I have an answer to.
You broke me. Thinking on it. I almost want to say like a boss type, but I think I'm leaning to just a very common enemy type.
Oh, good. 100% chance.
There's just something funny about any kind of small kind of grunt monster that has a big shield and a big sword. Kind of like the little guys in Zelda. They have their sword, their shield, but they're just useless. Geared out, but not fighters. It's pretty funny, but no. Favorite monster. Amy, what's a really cute video game monster? Moblins, those are funny.
Cute monster. I knew there was one here. I don't know. It's too hard.
It's Pikachu. Amy, one thing I liked about this game was that some mons really have a role well-defined, like Dandelion is totally geared to support play.
Now, see, my problem is I'm like, how hard can I hit? I am that child that still just gets rid of all the, like, buffing kind of offensive kind of moves, and I'm just like, how hard can I smack him?
You give me four moves that hit.
But, like, 100%. I love that. I love that.
That's for nerds. Those, like, I've lowered your attack speed and raised my defense. It's like, nah, bro. All four of these are a variation of smack.
These are just different schmacks.
Yep.
No need for buffs if they're dead. See, Jamie Prince knows what's up. Jamie Prince knows what's up. One thing I learned way too late was that I could actually fast travel.
Oh, this early? Like right now?
Yeah, not to many places, but like you can. And as you unlock more train stations, you can use those as well.
Interesting.
Hmm.
No, Jeff, you showed up late for the sequel talk. All of them have been said. MP3 monkeys, etc.
MP3 monkeys! Okay, good. We've got Kaylee back. Good. Because I wanted her where we were going. God damn, I need a bulletino. It's just a bullet.
Just a bullet? What? Feet. Like an actual bullet? The mon is just a gun. Speaking of which, when's Power World coming out? Oh, I'm excited. That's going to be some jank. Still nothing announced for it. We're going to get sued.
Bargo Busters.
Yep.
Escapists in disguise. Oh, no, I did the thing. I need to go up. But there's a rogue fusion up here, isn't there? Oh, no. There is not. Okay, we're fine. I miss having all my abilities!
Poor thing. What time is it? We've got 30 minutes, you could switch to your other one.
Nah, that's fine. That's fine. The people need to see the game, you know?
Yeah, they can see what to expect in the end game. Oh, it's not even end game by your description.
You know what? Why not? Why not?
Now Amy's gonna one shot everything. It's your other
I am not. I am not that strong. I'm not that strong. So this is me. This is my boy Boxley. He's so cute. I love it. Look at him. Look at my boy. Look at my boy. Oh, there's so much more on the map now. What do we want to do? Who do we want to fight?
Everybody.
Penny Dreadful kicked my ass.
Penny Dreadful? Is that what you said?
Penny Dreadful. That's one of the captain names. She kicked my ass. Let's go kill that one.
Worst recipe you ever made was soggy supermarket sausage with egg and barbecue sauce. And I ate all of it because I hate wasting food. Oh, yeah, same. But I kind of find it fun. you become a better cook by the bad things that you eat as much as the good stuff that you've made.
I am so going to lose.
There you go.
Oh, no, we're about the same level. This should be fine.
Soggy supermarket sausage. Wet sausage, wow. Pyromillion and Zed. All right.
Zed is the captain's name. So if it's like a character, they maintain their name. If they're not, they don't. Yep, let's do that.
Oh, every one of these mon games has to have that one sicko Pokemon that always has its tongue out.
Bleh.
Bleh. Bleh.
Look at Barkley. A dog with aviator caps on.
Yes, but so the cutest thing is, he is literally just a dog with a cassette tape around his collar. But he transforms into the Mons.
Oh,
and I think that's so beautiful. Thanks. Yeah, so he transforms into the Mons. Oh my god, I've just figured out how I know how many characters I have to face. Oh my god.
The tape's on the right.
The tape's on the right. It only just occurred to me. I was so into it. Anyway, so his like special monster is a bootleg version of the dog Pokemons that run around. I think that's so beautiful. Yeah. Yeah, he's a bootleg, and I just think that's so cute.
Love it. Worst part was that you found out that you wasted all the eggs in your house making that awful meal. I did that maybe once when I was young. I held on to that feeling of having wasted the last ingredients. Like, that scarred me. So I always double, triple check. Oh, my God. Nothing was sadder than trying to, like, make a cake as a youngster and you find out that you're missing an ingredient and you already went and mixed things.
And then just want to cry a little bit?
Oh, yeah. Yep. Into the batter.
Pours batter into the...
Pour batter. And now you make pancakes.
I probably should have fused earlier.
Why has Barclay got this big crystal in front of him?
Because he's protecting himself.
Why is it? Wait, what's dog ears do?
Extends the duration of status effects.
That's so good.
Which actually I might do. Because his elemental, well, technically a status effect. I don't actually know. I never tested that.
But now we live in an age of delivery if you're missing ingredients. I'd still rather eat the batter than, have eggs delivered to me at triple the cost, and it's already expensive. Yeah, exactly, Pacific Blue. Shoot, I'm missing the flour. Oh, well, I can substitute with rice. You just start getting weird with it.
I can substitute with rice. My mother-in-law, she lives by this ethos of, I can just put anything in, and her food is inedible. Like, it's so... I feel bad,
Your mother would rock chopped. Just that whole, and here's your secret ingredients. It's fine. It doesn't matter.
No, you can't swap that out for that. Like, that actually doesn't work. And I always thought that was pretty funny.
You can technically make rice flour? That's a thing, yeah. That's kind of what Pringles are made of.
This is what Pringles are made of.
So cute.
We're gonna fuse.
What is this? This here is a Pokemon cassette blue. Is this as cruel as Pokemon? Hold on. I don't know if this is real.
Who asked?
Andrew, he's just being facetious. Oh. It's a very funny thing, though, because I think PETA has been trying to get people to take their word for this, for cassette bees. It might have just been for Scarlet and Violet, though. I doubt they'd stick their nose up for this.
Wait, what?
Because PETA thinks that Pokemon is animal abuse.
I know.
Yeah, so anything even similar, they're just like, who wants to take our opinion? No one. What happened to the Persona stream from this weekend? All right, so Nick had some travel problems, and he had a big old migraine the day prior. And you don't really want to go into some Persona right after that.
You had the chance, Frost, to say Nick was sick.
What?
It just rhymes, and you didn't do it.
Nick was sick? Oh. Well, he wasn't sick. Is a migraine a sickness?
When he takes a 30-minute shower to try and get rid of it, yes.
I'd do it.
We're like, he complained once. He's like, oh, you took a while to get ready. I'm like, no, I didn't. I took less time than anyone else in this building. I'm like, what are you talking about? I said, you just spent 30 minutes in the shower.
Yeah. If we got things to do, I'm very quick. I take almost take a horse bath. But if no one's around, I could take my sweet time. 30 minutes. Yeah, I deserve it. I earned this.
I was like, can we take a moment to appreciate the T-Rex with a machine gun?
That's right. Artillerex. So good.
Thank you. I just wanted to point that out.
What an evolution. So anyway, he wasn't feeling up for it, so we postponed it to this coming Saturday. That's when he's going to hurt himself with Persona. And yeah, all will be well. Mm-hmm. Usually get visual migraines around this time of the year when it starts getting warm, but I haven't had one for years now. Good. I never had a migraine, but I got a visual migraine that freaked me out. I didn't know you could have migraines without pain. Oh. This game's intense.
Yeah, we're bringing out the big guns now. And I'm like, ugh.
Big axes. Wondering what happened at the Persona Marathon. Yeah, it's going to be this upcoming week.
Yeah, just postponed. Just postponed a bit at the last minute.
It's all that Twitter. Give us a migraine.
Does something to a man.
Right. Yeah, I've, I removed my Twitter from my phone. Well, I've hit it. I opened a folder that has like 50 bajillion apps I never use. So now I can't go looking for it. But if it's an important notification, I'll get those. Because I kind of need it for work.
I That's don't even get there. Notifications properly anymore. And then I'll be like, oh, I had no idea. Really? Like, I'll check my phone a day later and I'm like, oh, that would have been useful. Amy, why didn't you play golf last night? Because unfortunately, it's at 9 a.m. in the morning for me, and I work from 8:30 to 9:30 teaching group fitness. So I can't attend while it's at the current time.
Yeah, Jay was there because he was jet-lagged up the wazoo. Poor guy. Yeah. Hope he got some sleep. That's some wicked dreams from the golfing we did.
We win!
Did we?
We won!
Oh, you don't have to kill him. All right. That's good. Victory!
Woo!
It's adorable.
Fuck you, glitter bomb. What?
I would die for Barkley. Look at him. £14 for a rum punch cocktail. Was it a big one? It better have been like a gallon of it. And Amy, just want you to know, I love Dabrella a lot. She reminds me of my mom, who's a chef. She's also strong because she carries heavy kitchen stuff.
Damn straight.
Being a pirate today. Oh, that's right. Jay's being a pirate. He's having this like pirate fest thing and. And where was it, guys? Burbank, Brighton, Bristol.
He does so many weird things.
Who are we to judge? Painkiller was even smaller and 12 pound. What? No. Brixham might have been it. Who's Jay? Jermaine.
It's Jay.
Good old Design Delve. Likes to fill in for some streams whenever the crew's gone. There's a lot of editing work on Adventurers Nigh. That Jay. Susan, if you will. YouTube sends notifications on my phone way too late. Like Escapist post gets sent to my phone a day after it's posted. What? Have you changed your clock? Like, your date? Now the ghost of Susan, to be accurate. Yeah, the artist formerly known as Susan. Now Susan's ghost. Oh, you're not kidding. You could fly all over the place and dash. Look at you.
Yeah, it's the Bulletino dash.
Crazy.
Because it's a bullet. But look how fast.
The time on my phone is correct, but not the day.
Let's fight a rogue fusion. We're gonna kick its ass, but, you know.
We got ourselves a Traffalite? And another spring heel. Still don't know what those are.
You don't need to know. Don't think about it.
Are you sliding around like a Japanese anime mech? It's because we're going to have a freaking Armored Core 6 coming out. That's why. What is that? Dower Dodger. 100 bajillion cops. Just dropping in to say hi. Fun fact of the day. Colombian Customs plays Kalanjaz. Really? They're gonna kick out.
Why we can't use it anymore.
Because Colombia is going to copyright us.
There's so many cops. Oh my god! Thank you so much! I came in way too hard and fast saying I'm gonna kick some ass.
Hey, you did. Now look at you. Pride before a fall. It's fusion time. No. Aw. Too soon.
Too soon.
Jesus. What is that? Is that that mouse carousel thing you were talking about?
It's oh the my evolved goodness. Form.
That is
but
crazy.
But mine is a special version.
A joke, thought I was losing my mind because that seems so specific. What, the Kalan Jazz? Yeah. Nick actually is a tortured musician. He just moonlights at the Escapist.
We keep him locked away for good reason.
Oh. A weave a light and a traffic crab. I'm loving it.
Oh, yeah. Like, genuinely, I just had an absolute blast with this game. I just thought it was so good.
Mm-hmm. Game's aesthetic is freaking wild. Yeah, there's some games I love that just go like 3, 4, 5, 17 levels deep with their aesthetic. And they may not be like the best game, but the aesthetic is just top notch. Last time I had a game that did that to me was possibly Enter the Gungeon. Oh my god.
Yeah, right.
The gun puns, the aesthetic, but they just went all the way. They had one joke, but by god. They didn't tell it well every time.
And then I had a special Palangolin, but I think that's the one that you get by default when it's like, hey, have you heard about bootlegs? And then they give you one and you're like, this is the greatest day of my life! Right. Yeah, they give you one and you're like, oh, this is amazing.
What was the pre-stream music from last week when we streamed Mage Seeker? That's Path of Exile. What specifically? POE?
It's literally just always... I literally just have a thing that's just a combined thing of just like lo-fi music from the entire Path of Exile soundtrack.
Oh, this is just the whole thing.
Because that music... Yeah. Oh, literally, it's just like most of the music. I get fucked, the one that just fell in the water. Oh shit, glass tape. We're going! Oh, but it's only active for 3 minutes. Will that count if I sleep? Because I need to rest.
Gotta gun it, gotta run it. You can do it.
Oh, level 5 of Berkeley! He's my
what?
Best friend.
She's out of. Did you just have a coffee with Barkley?
Yeah.
That kills dogs.
This is just dog coffee. It's a fluffy. It's like what you give to babies.
Give what? There's different coffee for babies. All of Supergiant Games have the most alluring aesthetics. Agreed. But they don't do the punnery.
Ah, boo! I had to go like then and there. Ah!
This is here. Oh, Amy, I hope you played Dead Island 2 because between Yachts and Nick, it sounds like it's okay, but you and Frost are more fair. Wait, what do you mean we're more fair?
What?
I don't know where you're getting this.
I would argue I am typically more positive than fair.
I would say I'm more more neutral than fair. It's like, yeah, a lot of things are average to me, and I'm very unlikely to say, oh, it was hot garbage or it was amazing. I am looking to get into Dead Island 2 because I love Dead Island 1. Again, not saying it was amazing, but it was silly, goofy, and it was great. This one seems a little serious, which I don't know how I feel about that.
The Dead Island.
Yeah, the Dead Island 2. It seems a lot more serious compared to the first one. I don't care what people say. I like Dead Island. Yeah, I like Dead Island 1. Well, here's the thing. I never feel like I have to defend my liking of anything. The only thing I feel I have to defend is my stance, because people assume being in games media, if I like a game, it's because it's good. I'm like, no, that's a different story.
It's a very different thing.
I love Dead Island 1. Dead Island 2 is still goofy. Yeah, the part where Yahtzee was playing with Nick did not look very... It was just... Go straight line, kick a zombie here and there. Like, the first one was super zany. But yeah, we'll see. Maybe it was just a weird spot.
Who knows?
It's amazing as Marty's response. I do think Marty has the nicest ones, but that's because he minds his manners. The rest of us are prone to saying stupid things.
Thank you.
What it is. Bless you.
Thank you.
Oh, he has a little balloon.
He does have a little balloon. That's why he's the best boy.
He's the best boy.
I don't know what I'm looking for.
Oh, nice. You get your own cave systems. Lovely. Someone to kill, fight, maim.
Well, apparently I did exactly what I was meant to do.
Rob.
there we go. No, we're not robbing and killing him, Frost. Jesus.
I was just questions asked, Amy.
That's a Pokemon you'd like. It's called Terra Cooker. He
really,
things.
No.
Oh, God.
Is he any good at it? Ranger.
Well, I like that we both just fell down the abyss and we're going to fight in the abyss.
This is just like Lord of the Rings. With Gandalf and the Barlog, the Balrog. Demon just falling down a hole, fighting each other, no worries. God, this music is so
good. It goes so hard. It's so good. Yeah, fuck
you.
Oh,
poor guy.
Nah, he was a thief.
You said we weren't killing anyone. He looks dead.
The man looks dead.
And Mary, I'm with the £99. Thanks for helping me with my phone addiction. No worries, no worries. It's a dangerous thing, because for the longest time I'd defend my phone usage just like, there's some gems in this.
In
Reddit,
gems
in Twitter. Yeah, there's some gold in here. A lot of trash, but some gold. Nowadays, though, I can't even defend that.
No,
so,
you can't defend it.
Nope. So I can't defend Twitter. I can't defend Reddit. I can defend TikTok because the algorithm serves me.
Because the algorithm serves me.
It's so good. It's nothing but food and puppies. Grand. How's this not exacerbating a phone addiction? See, I've actually... One thing that helped with phone addiction once is switching to... I don't want to say meaningful media, but things with a purpose... would get me away from just like reflex browsing. Like I would look for videos on purpose. I would look for streams on purpose instead of just, I'm on Twitter because as soon as I go to the bathroom and drop my pants, my finger just goes straight to Twitter.
You're like, I don't know what I'm doing.
Ah. It's a reflex, just like, whoa. I actually found that taking Twitter off my phone. I just look down at my hand and go, I'm like, why am I swiping the screen over and over? I was like, oh, my hand's looking for Twitter. That's weird.
Oh God!
It's like a ghost hand just doing its own bidding. Uninstall every app. See, I can't. I use them for work. I think more devs contact me through Twitter than they do my email, which is on my Twitter.
That kind of makes sense, though.
Yeah. Probably just don't want to get caught by the spam filter, honestly.
Want to see my tapes?
Yeah, let's go.
Look at my tapes. I got an Apocrylips. I got an Arkid.
Arkid, okay.
Boltam.
Bolt, what is that? That's
I don't know what that one is.
That's creepy.
Bulletino.
Oh, yeah.
Burnus. Capricorps. Cluckabilly. That's just a chicken with a jacket. I like him.
And a knife.
No, it's his tail.
His tail is a razor blade.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a box cutter.
That's Cauldron.
That's adorable.
That's Farious. That's just Farious. Link. That's Hedgehurn. That's Jellyton. He's jelly. He's made of jelly.
He's jelly.
What is this on? It is currently on PC and PC Game Pass.
Surely that means Xbox too, then?
No. At the time of reviewing, the press release I had said Xbox and Switch coming later in the year. So they'll be out soon on other platforms, but currently it is on PC. Jumpkin? It's Jumping Pumpkin? Macabre, we've already seen. Manaspear. Mascot Toy. Masquerattle. Musketeer. Scampire. He's a little vampire. Look at him. He's so cool. Scubolrus.
What is
this? Scuba diving walrus. That's Southpaw. That's Stardigrade. That's just a butthole. That's
Thwackalot. Stardigrade. It's a water bear.
So what?
It is it's a water bear.
It's a butthole.
It's the tiniest little creature can survive anything, but yeah, it has a butthole mouth.
Thwackalope, I had a traffic crab, and traffic I have a winged loon.
Aw, he's so sad.
I was really upset with myself, which is why just then when it was like, oh, we know where X is, I'm like, I am gonna get it. Because if we look at my bestiary, I don't want to spoil too much.
Oh, wow, and there's still lots to be found.
Yeah, there's still a few I didn't find.
Yeah, like how many mons are in the new Pokemon? I like the small number of like there's 120.
So do I.
Okay, I can catch that.
Glassstain, I want that so bad, and I missed it the first time, and I was like,
oh. Glassstain, that's funny. Yeah.
Stained that glass. I could not catch to save my life. That was upsetting.
What? A Verivoir?
Yeah, so I there's still one ability I don't have. Capri.
Look at that. It's the Egyptian beetle. Bukyuni.
Undying?
Undying.
Yeah, there's some.
Then I'll get the Arkid.
No, I don't get the Arkid either.
Cryoshear. Does this game have shinies? Yeah, and they're called
bootlegs.
So you
can actually tell because in my party, see how some of them are just gray tapes? That just means they're normal. If it's red, it means they're a bootleg. So I currently have 3 bootlegs in my party. Now where is...
There's an ASAP rock song with the line, swapping survival tips with tardigrades bars. I played a rogue that was, you get to be a little tardigrade. It's adorable. Wasn't much of one. It was made for a game jam. It was fun. Land of Confusion.
Oh, in the station. Oh, okay. Where are they? They must be over here.
Push. Push. Tardigrades kind of go, noot, noot. Yeah, right?
They kind of what?
Newt Newt, it's the shape that the mouth makes. Yeah, the penguin, yeah. Newt Newt. Frost, I want to test myself with a more complicated recipe. What's a good one? I want to spend the whole day cooking something that turns out to be worth the time. Oh, God. Croissants. Oh,
are worth the time.
I think they're worth the time. Yeah, you hate yourself the whole time, but my God, if it's not delicious by the end of it. Toast with beans, mate. Why? I do love beans on toast. So good. But yeah, as far as like complex and all that stuff, freaking croissants, hand pulled noodles.
Oh,
yeah,
damn.
No. Yeah, I rage quit that.
I rage quit that.
Yep. I underestimated it.
I like that you don't rage quit games, because we had that conversation the other day, but you're like, oh, but the noodles, though.
Well, I did that to myself. I was hungry to begin with. So add in that you just spent like 2 hours ruining your dinner while you're hungry. Yeah, no. I said, that's enough of that.
I need to get to know what it's like to be a sad showerhead. I do.
Amazing. Favorite Marty moment is when someone convinced him to look up an anime called Black Bible live on stream. His reaction was priceless.
Oh, God.
I would not.
I know
what that is.
I don't know what that is.
No.
Seems like
Alt
it's F4? The best.
What was that? Alt F4? That's just the thing that closes your PC. Oh, it's a Steam game. Third person permadeath runner game. Try to overcome various obstacles until the end. Oh. Fun. It's a runner. That trailer told me nothing.
Isn't that the worst? When you watch a trailer and you're like, I feel like I should know more about this.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's go, Fountess. Let's go. Oh, that'll hit my pod.
I mentioned Bowsette and he didn't know about her, which shocked me given his Nintendo-ness.
Marty didn't.
Yeah, that's what Marty didn't know.
What? That surprises me. That does surprise me.
Do water burgers sell just water?
It's I hope
water.
So.
It's not spelled water, but yeah.
No, it's water burger. Come on.
Bossetier. Water burger. I recall someone told Casey to search up something weird and it crashed his PC. It's probably for the best then.
Wow.
What?
That's like next level to just crash a PC. Like, nah.
It's like your own PC says, no, I must save you by committing Sudoku. Boom.
Anyone in chat playing Honkai Star Rail?
The newest game by the Genshin Impact crew?
Yep.
No addicts here? No, okay.
Alex is loving life.
Wait, Bowsette's not an official Nintendo? I thought she was.
No, God, no.
Oh, I know what Black Bible is, don't you worry. That was one of the first lessons I got for being an initiate weeb, where they said, these titles here, just know they're hentai.
And you're like, oh.
Just don't look them up ever.
Torrent. What's sticky tongue? Oh, dang, it's double Fountess.
Dun, dun, dun.
That's kind of cool.
I've never met a double Fountainhead.
Never had a double faucet?
No.
Whoa!
What happened there?
Shit me with the 1-2-1-2.
Got obliterated. Soggy cactus lady Dimitrescu. I see it. It's that Resident Evil. Look at her. Sonic boom, man.
Jesus Christ. I'm going to lose.
You're over-leveled and she's still beating ass. What's happening here? How's that ain't family friendly, Frost? How's I supposed to know that? You seen some of Nintendo's party stickers? Weird Yoshi?
Like a weird Yoshi.
There's somebody in Nintendo that's trying to like push the envelope as much as possible. It's like, yeah, this isn't lewd.
This isn't lewd. You're lewd.
Yeah, you're lewd for thinking it's lewd. Can we stream one more hour? The game's pretty cool, and it's not like there's anything else to do.
Amy's got a job. Amy has a full-time job. It's Monday. This is just job one of three of my Mondays.
And Frost is hungry.
And Frost is hungry. Frost needs food. Amy needs second breakfast.
Yep. Did you guys ever play Shadows of Doubt? I have been, actually. I've been playing it. I'm too early in to have... to have a thought. First impression, though, it's got me. Well, I go, oh, all right. I'm involved. I'm immersed.
Do early we have access, flying too. Cars in the future? No, not yet.
No.
I wish I had better news for you. All right, I currently have like a type advantage on it, so maybe, just maybe, we can do it.
I believe in you.
Damn, Amy, I can barely take one job. Yeah, no, full-time job after this. And then I go teach this afternoon.
The Weeb 101, along with you, must watch Akira. Oh, God. Last anime I watched was episode one of Chainsaw Man. Pretty good, all right.
Oh, my God. Wait until you get, like...
All right.
Chainsaw Man lulls you, and you're like, okay. And then... out of nowhere, you just go, oh, fuck. And Birdie Wing's Girls Golf Story, the second half of that started dropping weekly episodes at the moment. Oh, my God. It's had the same effect. I was like, I love this show. This is great. And then it gets to, like, episode 14, and you're like, oh, fuck. It's amazing. It's amazing. Cannot recommend Birdie Wing's Girls Golf Story enough.
Keep going, Frost. This Chainsaw Man is something. It is something. I'm just very busy. And anime takes full attention because I like watching it. Watching it in the OG. Yeah.
And remember, I wrote an article about that.
That's right. Yeah, I can't understand them, but I recognize the voice actors.
I love that.
And that's very appealing to me. I like it. So I was sad in Blue Lock when Balls, what was his name? The guy that didn't make it into the later section.
Yeah.
Him. I was like, no, he's JoJo.
My boy, no.
That's my man. Please.
Oh, dang. Oh, yeah. Who's my favorite Chainsaw Man character? That's hard. I don't know.
The puppy demon chainsaw thing.
Oh, yeah, Pachita. Pachita.
The best one.
Or chat. That was Cassette Beasts. As I mentioned, I did a 3-minute review on this game, which is why it was super easy for me. I was like, on Monday last week, I was like, Nick, it's easy next week. I just do this. So yeah, if you haven't checked it out, please go check it out. Your support on my 3MRs means a lot. Maybe I'll do some more. Who knows? You just have to wait and find out. Totally wasn't your bag, but the bounce was good. Yeah, and like it's not some people's thing, and that's totally fine. But if this is your type of thing, you will love this game. Like I had an absolute blast with this. And yeah, the devs seem like a good sort. So definitely worth supporting them. What was my 3MR? My 3MR was for this. It was on Cassette Beasts. Frost, where can the people find you? What you doing this week?
You guys can find me right here as the cold take's going to come out. An early access tomorrow. Ooh, that's going to be a fun time. And then I'll be stringing along through other streams, I imagine. You know, like got your editor's hour, Persona stream coming through. Definitely be showing up to that. Who knows? Friday, of course, Childhood Classics, where we can grab either Hercules or one of your cabinet games that you found.
Yeah, we need to figure that out.
We got tons of options.
We got options.
We got options. We'll be fine.
We got options. Yeah, so Frost just lives here now.
I do.
Me, as I said, 3-minute review is up for Cassette Beasts. Check that out. Even though you've just got the extended 2-hour edition just here. Side Quest episode 2 is out to the public. And episode 3 will be dropping this week for early access. Episode 3, I am so excited to see how they've animated this episode. So I'm really, really excited for you all to see it. Have a fabulous, fabulous rest of the week, everyone. Have a fabulous start to your week. All the streams, all the good stuff coming back your way. And we'll see you later, everyone. Bye-bye!